Hello, and welcome to this video on what is citywide inclusive sanitation. In this module, we will cover what constitutes citywide inclusive sanitation. We will take a look at the four contextual layers, which we will consider to understand urban sanitation. And finally, we will review the six key principles of CWIS.
Citywide inclusive sanitation, or CWIS, is the guiding principle of this course. It is framed as an approach to urban sanitation where all members of the city have equitable access to adequate and affordable improved sanitation services through appropriate systems of all scales, including sewered and non-sewered systems, without any contamination to the environment along the entire sanitation value chain.
Citywide inclusive sanitation presents a paradigm shift from seeing urban sanitation exclusively as the extension of centralized sewer networks. As past decades have shown, a sole focus on conventional sewer networks cannot accommodate the rapid pace of urban growth and leaves large parts of the cities unserved or served with informal, uncontrolled sanitation services.
Citywide inclusive sanitation seeks to provide an integrated framework for planning and implementing an appropriate mix of conventional and non-conventional sewers, fecal sludge management, small-scale or decentralized sanitation, container-based systems, and the related services. The entire sanitation service chain is addressed in a way that fosters the engagement of all sanitation stakeholders, from the relevant government institutions to private service providers and communities, and that tries to maximize the synergies between them.
In many cities of Africa and Asia, urban neighborhoods can be roughly categorized as follows. First, well-planned areas, including city centers and economically better-off neighborhoods. Second, informal settlements or slums with high population densities and poor infrastructure. And third, rapidly growing peri-urban areas on the edge of many towns and cities.
Most cities have some sort of centralized sewer network, typically in the central business district and in better-off areas. The first question is to which extent this network can be realistically extended. Where this is not possible in a foreseeable future, alternative sanitation systems are needed. In large part of cities, non-sewered on-site systems and the related services are prevalent, and these systems are often informal and unregulated. There, proper fecal sludge management may be the solution. Depending on the situation, however, small-scale, decentralized sewer systems and treatment plants may be another alternative, for example, in residential compounds.
Such diverse contexts within the same city call for different service delivery models associated with tailored sanitation systems, from utility-managed sewer systems through to private vacuum trucks for the collection and conveyance of fecal sludge from pit latrines and septic tanks.
This combination of different systems and service types may be challenging for city managers as well as for residents. Overcoming these challenges requires establishing an effective enabling environment. Such an environment consists, among others, of appropriate policies, institutional arrangements, laws and regulations, the availability of skills and capacities, financial arrangements, and social-cultural acceptance by the population. We thus need to understand these four layers: the socio-spatial settings, the existing and potential sanitation systems, the related services, and finally, the enabling environment to make it happen.
Let us take a look at some of the key principles of CWIS. 1. Equity. Everyone in an urban area, including communities marginalized by gender, social, and economic reasons, benefit from equitable, affordable, and safe sanitation services. 2. Environmental and public health. Human waste is safely managed along the entire sanitation service chain, starting from containment to reuse and disposal. 3. Mix of technologies. A variety of sewered and non-sewered sanitation solutions coexist in the same city, depending on contextual appropriateness and resource recovery potential.
4. Comprehensive planning. Planning is inclusive and holistic, with participation from all stakeholders, including users and political actors, with short and long-term vision, incremental perspective, and synergistic with other urban development goals. 5. Monitoring and accountability. Authorities operate with a clear inclusive mandate, performance targets, monitoring requirements, human and financial resources, and accountability. 6. A range of business models. Sanitation services are deployed through a range of business models, funding sources, financial mechanisms to reach all members equitably.
CWIS is at the forefront of new development in the sanitation sector. And now that you have learned what CWIS is, in the following videos, you will find out how to tackle urban sanitation challenges using the CWIS approach.